Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, where one of the few things I talk about is how to build custom software using no-code platforms like Glide Apps. Today I'm going to introduce you to a client portal template I have built in Glide Pages. The idea of this template is to have a single platform for people inside the company and people in the client's company to collaborate seamlessly. In my last video, I showed you how to build a new project starter template. I made a few more changes to that template and I used that template as a starting point for this template. A link to the free copy of the new project starter template is in the description below. So let's begin. Now I have documented the structure of this template in Notion, and this is how I typically structure all my client projects as well. So I've defined roles at the top level and I have defined features for each role at the top level. So as you can see, there are three types of users: admin, staff and clients. And for each user, I have described what that particular role should be able to do in the portal. So for example, admin should be able to add, update, delete, or browse users, companies, projects, tasks, and files. Now, based on these features and roles, I have defined what the data tables in my app would look like. So I'll have data tables based on these features that I have defined, and these data tables are users, companies, projects, tasks, and files. I'm not going to go through each field under each table, but you can pause the video for a minute or two to understand what field goes under each table. So let's jump into the portal now, and I can walk you through how each user is able to use this portal. So currently, I'm logged in as a staff member, and these are the different roles I have in the app. I have one admin, I have three staff members, I have six clients, right? So when I'm logged in as staff member number one, this is what I see at the top in my portal. I see my tasks. These tasks are grouped by tasks that are already done and tasks that I have to do. At the bottom, I also see all the projects that I am the project owner for. Now, when you click on any of these task details, you will see the overall task description. You will see buttons to edit task details, even delete the task. You will see some basic information for the task and the files associated with the task. Here, you can quickly add more files as well. Similarly, I have a list of all my projects here as well. I can filter this list to only show projects for a particular company. For example, I can click on Company A and it will show me all the projects for Company A. I can quickly mark tasks as done from this view here and they will go into my done list. As a staff member, I can also see all the companies that I have on the platform that my agency or my company is working with. So Self is my own company as a staff member, and I have Company A, Company B, and Company C as clients. So I'm going to click on the details for Company A and see the overall details for that company. At the top, we have links to profiles of account managers and company point of contact. We can see at a high level how many projects we have at this particular company. I have a list of all client personnel who are working in that company. For each client, I'm showing the total number of projects that each of them is managing. Now below, I'm showing all the projects that are associated with this particular company. And here I can filter this list by who who is the project champion from the client's organization. Similarly, I can see a list of all the files associated with that particular company, a list of all the tasks associated with that particular company. I can do the same thing for other companies as well. And then I can also browse a list of all the projects. So here at the high level, I can see how many tasks are assigned for a particular project and how many files are associated with a particular project as well. So for example, if I select OWL, I can see that there are a total of 4 tasks associated with this particular project, and there are a total of 5 files. There are 3 files at the project level, and there must be a couple of files at the task level as well. Let's see. Let's find that. There's 1 and there's 2. So a total of 5 files associated with this particular project. At any point, I can add a new file to the project. I can add a new task to the project. For any task, I can add a file at any point in time. I'll come back to the project now. So I'm going to come back to the home tab and view this project as client team member. A client from our perspective should only be concerned with the status of project. So for example, this client is currently the project champion for the project called OWL. I'm going to click this project detail and see the status of this particular project. The client at any point can add more files to the project, add more tasks to the project, and for each task, they can add more files to the project. They can edit a task detail, they can edit a project detail, they can edit a file as well. It's very easy to add a delete button for a file as well. I have skipped that part for now. Let's come back to home and view this app as admin. So as admin, I have nothing to see in the home screen. I can create new companies, right? I can create new projects. When I switch a company, you will see that the list of project champions from the client's organization, they switch as well, right? And as admin, I can add new users to the platform. So I can add an admin account, I can add a staff account, I can add a client account. For each type of user, we are able to see the staff members' projects. If in case we are looking at a staff member's profile, we can see the staff member's tasks. At a high level, for staff, I'm showing the number of projects that a staff member is handling. For clients, I'm showing at a high level the number of projects that the client is handling. I can click on a client profile detail and see all the projects that they are managing and the status of each of their projects. As an admin, I can delete user profiles as well, but I cannot delete my own profile. So that is the overall idea of this client portal template that I'm going to publish to Glide Pages now. I hope you found this useful. If you have any questions or feedback, please leave them in the comment section below. If you need help with your Glide apps, link to my expert profile and my Calendly booking page are mentioned in the video description below. If you'd like to purchase my templates, a link to a collection of all my Glide apps templates is also mentioned in the video description. Once the template is published or approved, I'm going to include a link to this particular template in the video description as well. Thank you so much for watching this video and sticking till the end. Until the next video, it's goodbye from me. Thank you. Cheers. Bye-bye.